Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Please be seated. We welcome you to the 2022 coronation at Canton High School. I am Kent Knutson. I'm our high school principal. It gives me great honor to welcome our MCs for the evening, Carly Laubach, Natalie Myers, and Olivia Trum.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 2022 CHS Homecoming Coronation. Now, a word from Caitlin Sayre.
Hello, everyone. First, I would like to thank all of you for coming to such a special event tonight to honor the CHS royalty. Coronation started back in 1925 and has evolved into what it is today while maintaining many traditions. I feel so lucky to be a part of a deeply rooted community and work for a district that believes in doing things for the students. The reason I am up here, though, is to recognize my mom, Deb Peterson, a graduate from 1973 at CHS. She has been the coronation coordinator, decorator for probably about 30 years, and I'm not sure how, but makes it better each year. Another fun fact is she was crowned queen 50 years ago in 1972. Deb has put in an enormous amount of her own time and effort into coronation over the years and even made new royalty capes for the years to come. Making CHS homecoming a special occasion is a passion of hers. She has been working on tonight for the past 8 months, doing research, making phone calls, collecting dresses, and the homecoming memorabilia that you saw out in the lobby. She also spent many hours printing photos and making scrapbooks. I know she probably doesn't want me up here saying all these things, but I believe it is important to recognize her. So Deb, will you please come down? She was at the top, so I apologize. She is a firm believer that this event is not about her or us, it's for the kids. And so, on behalf of the Canton School District and our community, we would like to thank you.
Now let's introduce the candidates for Masters of Ceremony. Josh Merkel, son of Brett and Marie Merkel. Josh's favorite high school memory was receiving a restraining order against, alongside his partner in crime, Tyler Frick, from Mr. Andrew Olson in sociology class. His most influential people are his mother and father. Josh's advice to underclassmen is to respect your teachers and make friendships with them. Make friends with everyone else you can as well. Also to try out for everything, join teams, and be social. High school is short, so make the most out of it. His future plans are to partake in devious acts with Mr. Olson. Tyler Frick, son of John and Jill Frick. Tyler's favorite high school memory is putting up with Kane Wallner's antics on the way to volleyball games. His most influential person is his father. Tyler's advice to underclassmen is to suck up for a bit, and most teachers will like you, and get your work done. After high school, Tyler's plans are to take over the family business and build it into an empire.
Tayton Ossheim. Son of Aurora and Roy Ossheim. Tayton's favorite high school memory are the homecoming football games and winning the state championship for football as a freshman, which we all know was very cold but a bittersweet moment. Tayton's most influential people in his life are his parents. Tayton says, "My parents both are big influences in my life. They are always pushing me to be my best and assure me when things do not go my way." Tayton's advice to underclassmen is do not put work off until it's due. Stay ahead and put forth effort into everything. Also, do not be afraid to ask for help. After high school, Tate plans to attend college somewhere and major in nursing.
Kale Ask, son of Jeremy and Brenda Ask. Kale's favorite high school memory is celebrating Cullen Rutten's semifinal win at state his freshman year. His most influential people are his parents. Kale's advice to underclassmen is to get involved with sports and academics because you get to meet new people and learn many lessons. After high school, he plans to attend college somewhere for some kind of engineering. Nerd. Derek Teason, son of Chad and Kirstie Teason. Derek's favorite high school memory was going to Inspiration Hill Camp with the football team. His most influential people are his parents. Derek's advice to underclassmen is to branch out and get involved and do what you enjoy. After high school, Derek plans to attend college at UNL or USD for finance. The crown bearer is Jace Gannon, son of Todd and Sherry Gannon. Jace is in Mr. Mendrian's first grade class.
Now, our 2021 Master of Ceremonies, Peyton Eben, will install the 2022 Master of Ceremonies. The sword given to you represents strength, which has now been given to you by the student body. The cape of blue and gold represents pride and integrity.
On? All right. Wow, this is such an honor. I want to thank everyone who's helped me become the man I am today, that being my parents, my friends, the faculty here, the student body, everyone here who's just molded me and shaped me to be the person I am today, and I really appreciate that. What else am I supposed to say?
Congratulations, Josh. That is very well deserved. Now, let's introduce our queen candidates. Olivia Sorley, daughter of Jana and OJ Sorley. Olivia's favorite high school memory is winning the 2022 State Class A Girls Golf Tournament her junior year. At least she's better at golf than she is at air hockey. Olivia's most influential people in her life are her parents. She says her parents have taught her that being kind and working hard in life will get you far. Olivia's advice to underclassmen is work hard, it'll pay off. But also, don't forget to have fun. Enjoy your high school years. They go by extremely fast. After high school, Olivia plans to attend college somewhere and major in physical therapy. Mackenzie Bryson, daughter of Carissa and Doug Bryson. Kenzie's favorite high school memory is getting stranded at the USD campus on a HOSA field trip because Mrs. Hussman left the lights on in the minibus. After sitting outside for what felt like an hour, we had to go inside a frat house to get a jumper cable. Shout out to Joey Heikala for hooking us up. You the man. Kenzie's most influential person in her life is her grandpa Neil. Kenzie says he is the most selfless, caring, and hardworking person she knows. Her advice to underclassmen is be involved. These are events to enjoy and cherish. Take in each and every moment. Make it a point to attend all the games, dances, and more. Your classmates and friends work hard in these areas, and your support means more to them than you realize. You have nothing to lose. Mackenzie does not have a plan on what she wants to do after high school, but we all know she will be a stay-at-home golden retriever mom and have a pasture full of cows. Wait, where's mine?
Fallon Lundstrom, daughter of Rich and Gretchen Lundstrom. Fallon's favorite high school memory is pulling up to prom in a Frozen-themed caddy. Her most influential people are her sisters, Atlanta and Jada. Fallon's advice to underclassmen is to try to get involved with everything you can because that's what makes high school fun. Fallon's plans after high school are undecided, but who knows, maybe she'll go into law because she does have a history in the courtship.
Josh.
Laken Meister, daughter of Thad and Megan Meister. Laken's favorite high school memory was after a basketball game on the bus ride home, they had a wedding ceremony for Paige and Emma. Her most influential people are her parents. Her advice to underclassmen is to be involved in as much as you can and have fun. After high school, she has plans to go to college somewhere but doesn't really know where. Please DM Laken on Instagram at Laken M. Meister with ideas where to go. Kit Peltier, daughter of Kelly and Jill Peltier. Her favorite high school memory is being three-time Powder Puff champs about to make it four. Kit's most influential person is her best friend, Maeve Botel. Her advice to underclassmen is be kind to everyone and don't wait to do your schoolwork. Procrastinating will only stress you out. Her plans after high school are to attend college somewhere for something. Glad you've got it all figured out, Kit. The flower girl is Katie Narum, daughter of Jared and Lindsay Davey. Katie is in Miss Tutlin's first grade class.
We will now have the 2021 Homecoming Queen, Delaney Scott, install the 2022 Homecoming Queen.
I'm not really sure how Peyton avoided this whole speech thing, but so last time I was up here, I said that my plans were to go somewhere and do something, and luckily this time I have it a bit more figured out, but I am at USD down in Vermilion, and I'm studying business, and I'm having a good time. I really like it. I just wanted to say congrats to all you guys for being up here. I think you are all so deserving. And if I could give you any advice, it would be to soak up these moments, not only this week, but your whole senior year. It goes by so fast. And I hope you guys have the best time, and go Seahawks.
The scepter throughout the ages has been the symbol of authority. The robe of blue and gold is symbolic of the honor given to you. The crown indicates that you have been highly honored by the student body of CHS.
Well, I just want to thank everyone, especially our parents and Deb and Caitlin, for making this week so exciting and everything leading up to this week. And all of these girls behind me deserve this just as much. And I hope I can see you all at sporting events this week. Go Hawks!
Congratulations, Fallon. So very deserving. Congratulations to the 2022 candidates and your CHS Homecoming King and Queen, Josh and Fallon.
In addition to our wonderful students, tonight we have honorary guests that we would like to introduce. When I call your name, please stand. Al Buchans. There he is. Al Buchans was Master of Ceremonies in 1952. After high school, Al moved to Sioux Falls and worked at John Morrell's for a few years. He moved to Minnesota and worked for the NCR Corporations. He joined the Retail Data Systems Group as president of the Sioux Falls branch and retired in the early 90s. Al has four children and since retirement enjoys traveling, golf, and playing cards. He would like to congratulate each of the royalty candidates and wishes the best of luck to the football team. Thank you, Al. Thank you for being here. Also here tonight is Carol Stensland Thies. Carol was homecoming queen in 1959. After graduating high school, Carol attended Stewart School of Hairstyling and worked for a couple of years. She is married to Mike Thies, also a Canton graduate, and they have two sons. Once her boys went to school, she worked for the Sioux Falls school system as a librarian until she retired. Mike and Carol now live on a farm in Fairview. Today, she enjoys yard work and gardening. Thank you so much for being here, Carol. This next one is a duo. Would Sharon Berg Schwartz and Lyle Schwartz please stand and be recognized? Sharon was homecoming queen in 1958, and Lyle was homecoming court in 1958. Sharon and Lyle were involved in many activities at CHS. Lyle and Sharon were high school sweethearts and have been married over 60 years. After high school, Sharon worked for Farmer State Bank and D'Angelo's for many years. Oh, Dr. Angelo's for many years. Sharon and her husband Lyle have four children. Their son Jason was Master Ceremonies in 1989. In retirement, Sharon likes reading. They both enjoy following their grandchildren in their sporting events. They live on a farm, which Lyle has worked after attending SDSU. Thank you so very much, all of you. Thank you, Sharon and Lyle, for being here. We deeply appreciate it. Thank you.
house in Budapest, my hidden treasure chest, golden grand piano, my beautiful Castillo, you, I leave it all. My acres of a land I have achieved. It may be hard for you to stop and believe, but for you, you, I leave it all. But for you, you, I leave it all. Give me one good reason why I should never make a change. Baby, if you hold me, then all of this will go away.
My many artifacts, the list goes on. If you just say the word, I'll up and run. But for you, I leave it all. But for you, I leave it all.
Give me sweet the reason why I should never make a change. Baby, if you hold me, then all of this will go away. Give me one good reason why I should never make a change. Baby, if you hold me, then all of this will go away. My friends and family, they don't understand. They fear they lose so much if you take my hand. But for you, I'd leave it all. But for you, I'd leave it all. Give me one good reason why I should never make a change. Baby, if you hold me, then all of this will go away. Give me one good reason why I should never make a change. Baby, if you hold me, then all of this will go away. My house in Budapest, my hidden treasure chest, golden grand piano, my beautiful Castillo, you, I'd leave it all. But for you, I'd leave it all.
Don't you worry, don't you worry about a thing, 'cause everything's gonna be alright, everything's gonna be alright. So don't you worry, don't you worry about a thing,
'cause everything's gonna be alright, everything's gonna be alright.
It's gonna be all be alright.
I was starting to rise up,
head up in my eyes up.
One, two. Those guys weren't supposed to be done so fast. Good evening, everybody. I'm Corey Ulrichson, 87 check, graduate. Check. OJ, you're in the house. 87.
How about 90?
That just there doesn't sound right. 90.
I know Trum's in the house.
So I had to reach out to my daughter and say, hey, this is more your era. Is there a good song I should pull out for this? And she said, yeah, just look at my Spotify playlist. You'll find something. So I found something, and I'm going to play it. So Chris was cool enough to, hey, first of all, I wanted to congratulate you guys, Josh and Fallon. That's awesome. Congratulations on homecoming court. You can tell your old man you'll do something large amounts, not the time. You just got too much on your plate to bait and cast a line. You can always put a rain check in his hand till you can't. You can keep putting off forever with that girl whose hand you hold, swearing that you'll last someday further down the road. You can always put a diamond in her hand till you can't. If you got a chance, take it. Take it while you got a chance. You got a dream, chase it. A dream won't chase you back. If you gotta love somebody, hold them as long and as strong and as close as you can till you can. There's a box of greasy parts sitting in the trunk of that 65. Still waiting on you and your granddad to bring it back to life. You can always get around to fixing up that Pontiac till you can't. If you got a chance, take it. Take it while you got a chance. You got a dream, chase it. A dream won't chase you back. If you're gonna love somebody, hold them as long and as strong and as close as you can till you can. So take that phone call from your mama, just talk away, cause you'll never know how bad you want her till you went someday. Don't wait on tomorrow, cause tomorrow may not show. Say your sorries, your I love yous, cause man, you never know. If you got a chance, take it. Take it while you got a chance. You got a dream, chase it. Cause a dream won't chase you back. You're gonna love somebody. Hold them as long and as strong and as close as you can till you can't. If you got a chance, take it. Take it while you got a chance. If you got a dream, chase it. Cause a dream won't chase you back. If you're gonna love somebody, hold them as long and as strong and as close as you can till you can't. Till you can't. Thanks.
All right, I know you guys are gonna know this one. So, during the chorus, I invite. In fact, I encourage you to sing along, if you dare. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. The other night, dear, as I lay sleeping, I dreamt I held you in my tight arm. When I awoke, dear, I was mistaken. It's by my head and I cried. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. I've always loved you and made you happy, and nothing else could ever come between. But now you left me to love another, and you shattered all my dreams. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. Oh, please don't take my sunshine away. Oh, please don't take my sunshine away.
Class of 90 rocks.
Thank you all for coming. Just another announcement for all the high schoolers. The bonfire, the homecoming bonfire, is at my place tonight. So all high schoolers are welcome. It's right after this, so I'll see you there.
So before I start talking about the itinerary of the week, I just want to recognize the rest of these guys that I forgot to mention in my previous speech. So all you guys stand up, please, and be acknowledged. These guys are awesome guys, and any one of them are outstanding gentlemen. So I just want to thank them for just, being friends to me ever since I came here in seventh grade, and you guys have always kind of led the way for me and helped me along. Thank you very much. So tomorrow, Tuesday, we've got boys golf, JV and varsity, go golf, cross country and volleyball as well. That's all at home, I believe. Cross country at Sioux Falls Christian, that's my bad. And then Wednesday we've got boys golf again at EPJ, and then volleyball is Thursday at Dakota Valley. And then Friday, the big day is the homecoming game. We've got homecoming activities, the talent show, the pep assembly, homecoming parade, and the football team plays Del Rapids. It's going to be an exciting time. Hope we can see you guys everywhere we can see you, and go Seahawks!
There will be a receiving line with cupcakes and refreshments outside of the pack, like just out in the front where you guys came and walked in. Thank you for coming to the CHS 2022 Homecoming Coronation.